Welcome. It's going to be a great day. Let's start drawing. Okay, in the previous episode, we looked at creating gradations by using flat lines to build up tone and form and shape and shadows. But what if you don't want that to be your final look? There doesn't seem to be a pencil stub. You can't use your finger or tortillon to blend. But there is the palette knife. And that's the closest thing we can get to smudging and smearing and blending pencils. I'm going to look at the palette knife in depth a little bit later when we're dealing with paint, because that's where it's most effective, because everything that the palette knife can do is not going to be used to its full benefit just using pencil. So here's where the palette knife is located. The flat blade uses the flat of the knife to smear paint or pencil on a canvas or paper. The edge blade uses the edge of the knife blade to smear fine lines into the pencil work on the paper. The soft blade is a digital effect that pulls the pencil strokes along the paper around where your cursor is located. Blur is definitely a digital effect, similar to the Gaussian blur in Photoshop. And it just blurs the pencil strokes underneath where you place your cursor. And wet is a digital effect that simulates sprinkles of water, kind of smudging or wetting the pencil strokes on your paper. Now, when you're using the flattened edge blade, you have different settings that are available to you. Loading, this indicates how much pencil will be picked up by the knife before the stroke begins. So the higher the value, the more paint there is, so your paint will spread further. If you set the loading to 100%, then the pencil or the paint will never run out in a single stroke. Next, we have auto clean. And this is only going to work if your loading is set higher than zero. Your blade will be automatically clean between strokes. So if you lift it up off the tablet, then when you place it back down, it's going to be completely clean. Next, we have lock rotation. If this is turned on, then the angle of the knife will not change as you stroke. Then the slider will allow you to define the angle of the knife while you're drawing. If it's turned off, it will rotate to follow the direction of your stroke. Next, we have soft type. The settings that are available here is smudge. That controls how much the paint on the canvas is moved around as you apply a stroke. The higher the value, the further the stroke is moved. And with blur type, the settings you have available here is softness, and that controls how much blur is applied to the pencil strokes on the canvas. And again, the higher the value, the more the paint blurs. You do have a lot of choices here to create a few different effects. Also, you have wet type that turns the palette knife into a water sprinkler, and it sprinkles droplets on your paper. And these settings are available if you choose to use wet type. Fall off controls how far the droplets can fall from the center of your stroke. You have drip size, which controls the size of the droplets. And you have drip spike, which controls how spiky the droplets are when they hit the surface. Now, the higher the value, the more raggedy the droplets will appear, and the more raggedy the paint or the pencil strokes appear when it spreads. Next, you have drip spread, and this controls how pencil is spread through the area of each droplet. Higher the value, the further the pencil strokes will travel, and the harder the edge of the droplet becomes. Low values cause very little spread, and the result is a smoother droplet. Color drag controls how far the color on the canvas is dragged with the droplets as you move. higher value, the color will move with your stroke for a distance before running out. If the value is low, the color will not spread far. Okay, now we've seen a lot of variety with the combination of pencil and palette knife. Let me show you another way to cheat using stencils. Now with a stencil, you can easily keep going outside the lines, and when you remove the stencil, you have the shape that you want, whether it's a circle or something more complex. Another way to do it is to use the stencil so you can create a negative space on a background. Well, that's all for today. If you've learned something today that has value to you, please like, share, and comment. I like to hear from you. And subscribe so you don't miss an episode. And remember, just create.